Afternoon, gang. It's Tuesday, the 28th of March, 2017. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom talk. I'm firing on all cylinders for some reason this morning, boys and girls, or this afternoon. A little bit later than advertised, 10 minutes later than advertised. If you saw the little promo video that we always do now, just before the show starts here on Facebook Live, and also on Periscope as well, boys and girls, you're better off to join us on Facebook Live, to be honest. You get the different things happening on the screen there, okay? But yes, if you saw the promotional video, it did jump in the middle. Did you see it jump in the middle? Which I identified the fault, boys and girls. Chris Reardon, Technical Service, identified the problem, and that's been sorted. So we'll have no jumping videos. Thank you very much, dear. Jumping, jumping, jumping. Anyway, couple of new features in the show for you today. I have been working very, very hard. New features, but I mean red and blue today. Does that go to you? Is that all right? New features in the show, and those features are, and I'm going to start off with one of them, Facebook statuses. You know, often you go around these Facebook statuses. I'm not talking about the boring ones. You know, pictures of people's dinner. I see that Alan Russell yesterday posted a picture of his breakfast or his dinner. How totally and utterly uninteresting to see pictures of people's meals that they're about to eat. What the hell is all that about? So we're not going to do the boring ones, but there are some very, very funny Facebook statuses that I come across day in and day out. And I thought, why not share them with you today? They really are very good. You know, and if you see any that you think are funny, please send them over in perhaps a little private message. Don't put it on my wall, because then everyone's seen it before I've read it, and then it'd be pointless kind of reading it again. But you probably see statuses of people, and possibly the same people do those statuses, and are actually very funny. They could almost be writing comedy. So we're going to be doing Facebook statuses. I've already printed a load off here, ready to read out to you. All right, boys and girls. And also an item of fake news. But it's all fake news. Fake news. I think... No, if he wasn't so scary with his finger on the button, I think Donald Trump is one of the funniest people I've ever seen on the telly. I mean, is he actually a real president, or is it some sort of permanent comedy show that the American TV people have introduced to us? I actually think some of the stuff he does he says is extremely amusing. One of the things he keeps saying, it's all fake news, ladies and gentlemen. All fake news, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so every day I'm going to identify a piece of fake news for you within the show, but I won't reveal to you which is the fake news item until right at the end. So that will keep you guessing, all right? Just a couple of little new bits and pieces. I hope you like the new features. I decided sort of to work a little bit more on this programme and perhaps improve it a little bit rather than me rabbiting on about what I'm up to. Although I will still do that. Don't worry. That's coming up in a minute. So this morning's Facebook, or this afternoon's, let's say hello to a few people who are with us. Good afternoon to Adam Tubero, who has arrived by carrier jet. By Harrier, how did you get back here, darling? By Harrier, not Harrier, oh, Ryanair, was it? Was it Ryanair or EasyJet, one of those? Adam's back from his holiday in Gran Canaria, and he went on a camel ride. Oh, no, dear, I can't be doing anything like that. Oh, I don't think I'd like to be on a camel. Do you know, I can't remember the last time. Have I ever been on a horse? I remember being on a donkey. I do remember being on a donkey years ago. I do, and you know, I saw donkeys. The last time I saw donkeys was about a year ago when I went to the most awful place in the world, Skegness. What a dump that is. Have you been? Oh, what an absolute hellhole. It's just horrendous. And the donkeys, and those poor old donkeys. Oh, my God. You want to see these great big fat people approaching those. The donkeys' faces droop down when they see, like, me approaching them. I wasn't going to put a donkey through my weight sitting on one of their poor little backs. Those poor little donkeys. Yes. Anyway, Adam's been for a camel ride in Gran Canaria. All those things to do in Gran Canaria, and he's gone on a camel ride. I'd be front. They spit at you, didn't they? Oh, hang on. Something just dropped out of my ear then. What is that? What the hell? hell was that? Hang on a minute, let me just check. Seriously, something just... What the hell is that? Come out of my ear hole. Oh, I know what that is. Oh, that is disgusting. What it is, I've got these eardrops. Okay. I had... Hang on a minute. I'll tell you what happened yesterday. What happened... Oh, I'm not going to show it to you. That's gone straight in the bin. I've got these eardrops. You remember a couple of weeks ago, I told you I had extremely itchy ears. Well, the doctor, he said there didn't seem to be anything wrong, but they were a bit dried out. So he gave me these eardrops. So I read the instructions and he said that the oil, because I go swimming a lot, the chemicals in the water dry my ears out and my ears looked extremely dry inside. So these eardrops, you drip, put one drop in, I think, and it's supposed to keep your ear moistened, or because if you scratch your ear, you know, it's kind of waxy, isn't it? So this is supposed to make it more waxy or oily again, like it should be without going in the swimming pool. Okay, so I read this and it did say on there also removes hard wax. Well, I didn't think I had any hard wax in it. Not till that moment a few seconds ago when a bit just dropped out onto the desk. How disgusting is that? Oh, it's a good job someone wasn't licking my ear, wasn't it? Because some people like doing that, you know. Oh, there's some very strange things people do in private. They really do. Dreadful people. Thank you, those of you that are sharing the video on your wall or on Periscope. Thank you very much. That's much appreciated. Very, very kind of you to do so. Thank you for those of you sharing. Anyway, yeah. So this stuff said it gets rid of hard wax. So I haven't been using it because my ears haven't been itching recently. I think whatever was wrong has sorted itself out now. However, yesterday, and I meant to tell you this yesterday I came in from the swimming pool. And as I bent down to open the bottom lock on my door, there was a sudden in my ear. And I think a fly had accidentally flown into my ear and then flown back out again. Oh, isn't that... I don't know how it managed to get into my ear hole. I must have very big... Have I got big ears? They look should look very clean now. They should look a bit clean now. And... I thought, oh, that's disgusting. You know, and I thought to myself, what if the fly was carrying some sort of bacteria or virus in the fly? Because they're disgusting, aren't they? Horrible flies. Oh, I think they're disgusting things. Anyway, so this fly, I thought, oh, my God, you know, I was a bit concerned. So I got the drops and I thought, well, I'll drop one of those oil things. And I think there's slight antibacterial properties in it as well. So I'll drop one of those in my ear and that'll be okay. So I got it and I did a little drop like that. And immediately you lose all the sound, don't you? It sounds like you're underwater. And I just left it at that. Now, I'm not keen on using this stuff because it stinks. This stuff stinks like a felt pen, you know? I bet you was at school, weren't you? You was at school like this, getting at the desk, getting higher and higher at the desk. Yeah, 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 man. Can I have some more felt pen, please? Miss, can I have another felt pen? This one's run out now. Well, you're a bit like that at school. Well, this earwax, this eardropper stuff smells like that. And once you've dropped it in your ear, you can't get away from the smell. I mean, I suppose if you ran really fast and the wind would blow the smell backwards. But of course, the moment you stop, the smell comes back again, doesn't it? So it's quite a strong smell that you have to put up with. Anyway, so I did that yesterday and I thought no more of it. Anyway, so I've gone to bed, got up, done today. And while I was sitting here, suddenly I heard something drop in my ear and it was a piece of dry wax, which ended up on my desk in front of my ear, which fortunately you didn't see. How disgusting is that? Yes. Anyway, so we're saying hello to the people that are with us this morning. Jerry Millen's morning. Morning, Jerry. Well, it's afternoon, dear. I mean, it may be morning for you. You get up so late, don't you? Maybe I should do an earlier show to make sure that you get up early enough. How about 7 o'clock in the morning? Does that suit you? Would you like me to do an early show one day? Like a really early one? Because sometimes I wake up and I'll toss and turn a bit. But if you can't get back to sleep, you can't get back to sleep. Now, normally, oh, actually, there's a story about that. I'll come to that. I'll come to that later on. There's eventually, I'll give it 20 minutes, half an hour. And if I can't go to sleep, I get up and have a cup of tea. 5, 6 o'clock in the morning. I have a cup of tea, watch a bit of television, usually the news. Then I go back to sleep and then I can sleep again. But what I could do, if I do that one morning, sort of, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 o'clock, would you like an early morning show? I mean, I don't know how I'll be able to function at that time of the morning, but that'd be quite easy. Because we've done early-ish morning, like 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. We've done mid-morning, 11. We've done early afternoon. We've done late afternoon. We've done nighttime and we've done late night. But we've never actually done sort of 3, 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning, have we? 7 o'clock in the morning or even 8. Somewhere between that. If I wake up early, would you like an early morning show like that? Who would be up? I mean, do you want to leave your phone number so that I ring you up and make sure you're there? I don't want to be sitting here talking to myself all day, do I? Which, to be honest, is what I do with most of my time. I just walk around the house talking to myself and the cat. And she's not bothered anyway, as long as she gets her food down. I can do that. Rod says, hello, Rod. Lovely day again in Bedford. That's in New Milton Keynes, isn't it? I know where that is, yes. Thinking about cleaning the car, only thinking. Oh, Rod, don't bother with that. Go and take it down one of those little car cleaning places. They're grateful of the work. You know, and you get some lovely lads there cleaning your cars off, don't you? Well, off sometimes. I mean, can you just imagine? Can you just imagine, Rod, if you took your car in to be cleaned and four people looking roughly like me went to clean it? I mean, you wouldn't bother, would you? We want to see young, good-looking lads cleaning cars. Thank you very much. Maximum age, 35-ish. 35-ish. And then they can't be fat. They can't have a little bit of a stomach like me. They must be thin. Not thin, but you know what I mean. Nice shape. That's what we want cleaning our cars. Not some bloody whirring brush on each side. Dear me. Good afternoon to Tweety Charlotte. Tweety Charlotte, I think, actually, let me have a look. No, it's not. No, I thought I had one of your Facebook statuses. They're coming up in a second. Hello to Tweety Charlotte, who's in the States. Good afternoon, my darling. Grant Boatman's with us in Greenwich, which is like a posh part of London. Greenwich is a very posh part of London. Except the part of Greenwich that Grant is in is not posh. Oh, ghastly area. He don't come out of his house after 6 o'clock at night, you know. Dangerous place, dangerous. Fortunately, Grant has guard cats. Guard cats, which is so much better than guard dogs. Because guard dogs are a bit stupid. I'm sorry, if you've got a dog, it's true. You know, someone rings a bell. Gonna bite your hand off until you put your hand in your pocket and chuck a bit of steak down on the ground. Oh, then they're straight to the steak, walk in the house. Guard cats, no. Once, if a guard cat doesn't like you, you are in serious trouble. They will jump at you and cling onto your face like that until you go away. Watch out for guard cats. Good afternoon to Vectis, who says, if you're going to use that camera angle, tidy up. No, that's the whole point of it, Vectis. That's the whole point of it. You see it as it is. You see it as it is. There's the other camera angle there. When we move, in about a year's time, into the next door room, which is almost three times the size of this. I intend to do that possibly next year. We're going to move into the very large studio. Not now. Adam the plumber's going to help me with that with his DIY skills. DIY skills. I wish I had some of those. Good afternoon to Alan Russell, who said, did you mention my name? I certainly did, Alan. But unfortunately, you didn't hear what I said, did you? If you were with us at the beginning of the show, like everyone else, you'd know what I had said about you. But there you go. There you go. You couldn't be bothered to get up out of bed, could you? Eh? Couldn't be bothered to get up. You'll have to watch the replay again later on the United Kingdom Talk iPlayer. Thank you very much. Grant says he has a dog as well now. Well, I bet the cats keep that in check, don't they? Cats are usually in charge of the dogs. You watch. I bet I'm right there. Adam says, bad goes my chance of cleaning your car. I'm sorry, Adam, lovey. No, darling. Come on, Adam. You would want to sit in the car next to me and watch the lads, the nice lads, cleaning it. In the summer, they take their tops off. Oh, God's sake. It's too much. Too much for a middle-aged white man sitting here It really is. They take their tops off. All the nationalities of the world, and they're working on your car. That one's nice. That one's nice. That one's nice. Could you move on to another car, please? Yes. Alan's in Braintree in Essex, babysitting for his niece, autistic niece and nephew for a studio. Oh, good luck to you. You'll enjoy that. You get a lot out of doing that, don't you, looking after children. I love it when I go and see my great nieces and nephews up in Lincolnshire there. Adam says, the Chris Reardon breakfast show, but please don't talk about earwax. Not at breakfast time. Has that ever happened to anyone else? You know, you might be doing something, walking along. What's that in my ear? And it's a big piece of wax dropped out. Mind you, perhaps this, I'll be, I've, one, two, one, two, hello. What's it sound like? This ear does sound louder now than that one. Maybe the same will happen. Shall I put some in that ear as well and see what happens? But that's taken like 24 hours to drop out. Oh, ghastly. Hello to Gary Davidson, who's with us this afternoon. Hello, Gary. and Kevin Webster's there as well. Danny Davis in Wrexham. In Wales is with us. Paul Dow is in North London. Paul, you didn't come for your mug yesterday. I've got a mug in the car for you, Paul. Don't worry. It is safe. Waiting for your little lips to clasp around it, OK? And Jane West is with us this afternoon. Jane West. Right, let's do some of these Facebook statuses. Hello to Duke. Good evening, Duke. Nice to see you, sir. I just saw a message flash up from DHL. I don't know what that was. A message just flashed up on my phone from DHL. Wayne is with us. Good afternoon, Wayne, who says 54 inches of Chris. 54 inches of Chris. Nope, don't get that. Anyone get that? Anyone get that? 54. Ah, Danny Davies is watching me on a 54-inch TV. That's it. Thank you. Thank you, Danny. On a 54-inch, can you take that? Can you take watching me on in such a large size? God's sake. And Grant says, yes, indeed, the cats do look, are in charge of the dogs. You watch cats, they absolutely do. They tell the dogs what to do. So this morning, I've been searching around on Facebook for the Facebook messages, the status updates. So here comes this morning's interesting Facebook updates. Three here by a young lad called Ashley Royce. Now, his Facebook statuses are hilarious most of the time. OK, hilarious. He used to come along to Belushi's in Hammersmith, where I used to DJ on Saturday nights about 5 years ago or so, something like that. So here we go. He's a ladies man. Why do girls fake tan that much? They look orange. If I want a girlfriend, I don't want. I've said that all wrong. We need to rehearse the show a little bit more, I think. Why do girls fake tan so much they look like orange? I want a girlfriend, not one of my five a day. Oh, it's true. It's not just the girls, though, is it, Ash? Have you seen some of these blokes on the telly? Jeez, how much orange stuff do they want to look like? Dreadful. Ashley, another one from Ashley. There's three from him. Women, oh, this is a bit rude, this one. Not very rude, just a bit rude. Women only have trouble parking because we are always being lied to about what 8 inches is. Oh, that's really sexist. Or you can't say. No, it's not. It's a joke. Get real. There was a bloke on the radio last night on LBC, Marcus Collins, who was saying he's had enough of all this politically correct rubbish and we should be able to turn around and say, no, it's a joke, get a sense of humour, go away, we're not interested. And that's how I feel about it now, to be honest. I'm sick to death of all this politically correct. We're worried about offending people left, right and centre. So if you haven't got a sense of humour, go away. It's here, it's a joke, dear, it's a joke. One more from Ashley, who says, one of my best feelings is finally losing feelings and your attachment to someone that isn't good for you. Now, that's a good one, isn't it? That's a good one there. So thank you very much for those, Ashley. By the way, I haven't got permission to read any of these out. I just nicked them off the internet. And I will, of course, post the show on these various people's walls so that they know I've read out their Facebook statuses there. OK, Robert Brown. Robert J. Brown. Hello, Robert. Lovely man. Who is quite right in what he writes this morning. Why are we giving out prescriptions for remedies which are cheaper in a supermarket, such as gluten-free food and other items which should not really be paid for by the government? Now, I totally agree with this. I'm hearing prescriptions going out here for stuff like gluten-free bread. Now, gluten-free bread, which I've tried, incidentally, you've got to try a lot of them, gluten-free breads, before you find the one you like. Okay, there's a lot of them, and they just taste disgusting. There is a couple that are all right. But nevertheless, to write out a prescription for gluten-free bread so that they get it free, when gluten-free bread in the supermarket is about £1.50, £2 a loaf for gluten-free bread. But it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous when you can buy this. For me, personally thinking, okay, I think prescriptions should be tablets, puffers, things that are actually helping you save your lives. But bread and gluten-free food, now go and buy it yourself in the supermarket. So that's very, very sensible one there from Robert. Thank you, Robert. Michael Milner writes this one, which is very worrying. If you work on cars, okay, if you work on cars, you might want to think of this one. And Michael writes, I think I've figured out why I've been ill for the last 2 months. First sign of carbon monoxide poisoning. It's ever since I've changed the exhaust on my car. I've been feeling really ill 24/7. So that's it for my Calibra till it's fully fixed. Oh, blimey. I mean, you've got to be careful with that, Michael. Gosh. Carbon monoxide. This is why you're supposed to have your boilers and things checked out every year at home as well, isn't it? You don't want carbon monoxide poisoning. You're lucky you've actually put two and two together and worked out that that's what's causing you feel ill, because that stuff can suffocate you and poison you and you'd be dead, but you won't know it's happened because you just go to sleep. It doesn't really have a smell, does it? I must say, years ago, I had a Toyota Aygo, and it was really, I got 160,000 miles and then things started going wrong, so I got rid of it. But one of the things was it would fill up, the inside of the car would fill up with diesel fumes. Yeah, so I took it straight in the garage. And of course, they won't let it out until it's fixed. It was filling up with diesel fumes. Something had gone in the engine. I don't know what it is. We don't do cars, do we? Neither do you, Michael, by the look of it. All right. Hello to Tanya Sheridan. Tanya, regular correspondent to the show, who said, I would like to apologise for anything I have done, haven't done, will do, won't do, will think of doing and won't think of doing. I hope that covers it. Excellent. Excellent, these statuses. And these, I found all these within 10 minutes of just looking around on the internet. Remember, if you see a good status, please private message it to me, or you can email it through to me, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk, and I'll happily include those in the shows, the ones that I think can be included, all right? Might not include all of them. Please don't be offended if I look at it. I might think, oh, I'm not sure about that one, and I don't read it out. Please don't be offended by that. You know, I'm just trying to sort things out like that, okay? Good afternoon to Sean. Sean Bolger, who was on Talk Radio years and years ago, who writes, apologies all for the next couple of days. It seems I have a threat. No, sorry, this is from Dave Lynn. I beg your pardon. Dave Lynn, international cabaret drag artist. He's been in the film, damn, what's it called? Beautiful. Beautiful Thing. He's been in the film Beautiful Thing. And Dave writes this morning, he's obviously not using his spell checker, apologies to all for the next couple of days. It seems like I have a threat and chest infection. So bed and tick. A threat. He's got a threat. You are a threat, Dave, to all these young other drag queens, dear. They're scared of you, lovey, because you are international celebrity, lovey. Thank you, Dave. That's a good, excellent one. And one more from Sean Bolger. Now, Sean used to be on Talk Radio and I think LBC as well here in the UK, who writes, I've had rather enough of Theresa May and particularly her knack of talking to us like a class of badly behaved seven-year-olds. Well, that's what you are, Sean, lovey. That's why she's talking to you. Like, if you behaved, you wouldn't be spoken to like that, lovey. All right? So there's this morning's Facebook profile updates for this evening, boys and girls, or this afternoon, and I shall find out another load on the next show for you, okay? Some of your messages coming in. Excuse me a moment. Let's have a cough. Facebook messages coming in. Good afternoon to Dino, who says, what's the phone number? Phone number not open yet, Dino. Phone number opening very shortly, as in now. Lines are now open. 020-8144-3477 is my local London number. If you want to call in about anything that we're chatting around today, boys and girls, 020-8144-3477. Or you can call in on our Skype name. Our Skype name is United Kingdom Talk. All one word, United Kingdom Talk, or 020-8144-3477. Dino says it is indeed cheaper to buy gluten-free stuff from the supermarket than pay for it on the prescription. Because prescriptions are, I think, about £8, £28, £30. I actually have quite a lot of medicines. Not loads and loads, but I do have some medicines that are regular, which I have to pay for. I bought the National Health... Oh, gosh, what's it? National Health Service little card, prescription card, which costs about £105, £110, somewhere around that. You buy that annually, and for that £110, you have as many prescriptions as you want. So you need to work out in your head, is it going to be cheaper? So maybe you only have one prescription a year. Well, that's only going to cost you £8, isn't it? £8.20, whatever it is. But I have quite a lot. And I think I've worked out I'm already up to about £60 or £70. And I've only had the card 2 months. So it's worth that for me having it for that. And we've got Danny Davies on the line in Wrexham in Wales. Hello, Danny.
Good afternoon.
All right. Afternoon to you, sir. Shall I bring up your picture? Shall I bring up your picture? There you are, Danny Davies. There we are. Danny Davies.
Can we change that picture? Please.
Well, no, darling. I mean, I think it makes you look young and thin like you used to be, lovey.
Yeah, that was taken when I was in Ibiza.
I know. It's quite a nice picture. Don't use one of the recent ones, whatever you do, lovey. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. What are you chatting in about today, Danny?
Well, the prescriptions thing that you're going on about.
Yes.
Because I live in Wales, I get mine for free.
Right. Oh, hang on a minute. What's all that about? What do you mean free? Are all prescriptions in Wales free?
Yes, they're all free. You don't need to pay for them because the Welsh government subsidised them.
Oh, I know that's the case in Scotland, isn't it?
I'm not too sure about Scotland, but Wales, yeah, we can go to the doctor, see the doctor, go into the chemist and wait for our prescriptions and they give them to us and we don't even have to pay.
Oh, I might
whatever
move. Have you got
have
you got space in your home for me? Would you like me to share your little house with you, lovey?
There's space for you, Chris.
Oh, thank you very much, dear. I can't have anyone living with me. Oh no, that would do my head in. Oh, I think you become selfish after a while. You know, you can't share the space anymore. Oh, it would do my head in. The fact, you know, I might, for example, when I've done late night shows, well, I wouldn't be able to do those, would I? You know, because they might be asleep or making noise or things like that. Oh, no. Anyway, David, Danny, so free prescriptions in Wales. Well, that can't be bad, can it? Do you feel you should play, though?
Yes.
Because you've got a job. Have you started your new job yet?
Yes, I've started my new job now, yes.
Oh, fab. And how's that going?
It's really good. The early mornings are starting to creep up on me a little bit.
Ah, well, you need to go to bed a bit early. Are you going to bed early or not?
I go to bed about 7, 8 o'clock.
Oh, that is quite early. And what time do you get up?
2, 3.
I think you need to be going to bed about 5.
Yeah, because I have to get up, have something to eat, and then make my way to work. So.
Yeah. Difficult in the summer, though, isn't it? Getting up, going to bed at 5 in the afternoon, especially if it's a hot day.
Yeah.
Can you afford one of those portable air conditioner things?
Well, what I'm thinking about doing is getting some blackout blinds.
Yes, yes. But the other thing is,
leaving the window open.
We're going to get into some hot weather, you know, in a couple of months' time, and you won't be able to sleep in the afternoon if it's hot. I mean, at least have a fan in there, or you can get. I mean, you could probably get a second-hand air conditioning thing. I think I bought one actually off eBay for about £100 once. Could you afford something like that, or?
I've got a fan already.
Oh, right, okay.
So like a tall one.
Yeah.
That covers the whole room.
Yeah.
But when I was living in Manchester and working there last year on nights.
Yes.
I was coming in at 7 o'clock in the morning.
Right.
And obviously it's bright that, well, I was leaving work for six and it was still bright. And sometimes if it was really hot,
the
sun was
yeah.
beaming down, it was really hot at 6 a.m.
I noticed.
So when I was getting into bed,
yeah, go on.
Like 8 or 7:30, 7:45.
Yeah.
Mm. It was just literally really hot. And because I was living in, because it was a converted attic,
right,
and we had Velux windows.
You had what?
Velux, you know, skylight windows.
Oh, yeah. I know those. I was seeing someone, it was about 8 years ago now, and he had one of those. And honestly, the sun comes through that first thing in the morning. They're a nightmare, they are. I don't think I'd want one of those. What do you call it? A velo window?
Velux, V-E-L-U-X.
Velux. Why aren't they just called skylights? Is that a different thing?
Skylights, I think, square, I think.
Oh, right, yes, like... yes.
But I just call them Velux or skylight Velux. Windows. They're the same thing.
Velux. But I like that word, Velux. Yes, Velux.
It's a good word, isn't it?
It is a good word, yes.
We should have a new feature, Word of the Day.
Word of the Day. Oh, I could come out with a lot of those. I'm just a bit concerned there's more wax going to drop out of my ear any moment now.
So... you could go to your doctor. You could get to your district nurse and have the ears syringed.
No, because I don't think there's anything wrong with them. I can hear everything. I don't know where it came from, that bit of wax. Dreadful.
But yeah, you can go and get them like syringed for free.
Yeah. I know. Oh, my mate gets that done. Ray Reynolds has had that done a few times. He says it's a bit messy, but it kind of. Although he had it done last time and it didn't make any difference to him, so I don't know. One of those things, I suppose, Danny.
But back to the story. So when I was sleeping through the day,
yes,
and it was really hot, I kept on waking up.
Nah, it's no good.
It's really hot. And...
get yourself a set of one of those portable air conditioning things. You can put the tube out the window or something like that. Are you on the ground floor?
No, I'm in a house.
Oh, excellent. So you're upstairs, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, you get one of those air conditioning things, just put it on, stick the thing out the window, try and block off the gaps, block up the gap, because presumably you won't be able to cut a hole through the wall, will you? And that's what I did in my bedroom. I cut a hole in the wall myself, and then I had to get someone in to fix the hole because I'd made it too big. DIY Chris, you don't want to call me for your work. So the pipe in my bedroom goes out, and that unit is about 12 years old now, if not more. It's about 12 years old, that unit I've got in my bedroom. And in the middle of the summer, I turn it on about half an hour before I go to bed, close the door, sweltering hot outside. And then about 3-4 o'clock, I open the door, close it, and it's lovely and cool. And you just go to bed. And it's lovely. Yeah. It works really well because I couldn't sleep in the heat. Oh, no. And imagine going on holiday with no air conditioning somewhere like Australia or America or Florida in the summer. That must be awful. Awful.
They do have air conditioning there, though, don't they?
Yes, they do. Well, most of them do. And yes, you stay in a hostel. In the hostels, you know, when you've got about 10 people in... Well, I mean, I could never do that, but lots of young people do that. They stay in hostels where there's, I don't know, 2, 4, 6, 10, 16 of them in one room, you know, in bunk beds. And they got no air conditioning. Sod that. No, thank you.
No, I wouldn't do that.
No, not me either. Well, thanks for calling in, Danny.
Thank you.
Nice, I hear your little voice. Carry on working. And you get to bed at 5 o'clock. See if that works for you.
I'll try and I'll correspondent to you tomorrow about
Please
that.
Let us know. Yeah, try and go to bed. The only thing is, if you've gone to bed at 8, you might not be able to sleep at 5. What I'd do, if you've been going to bed about 8, tonight go to bed at 7, tomorrow at 6, and the day after at 5. And then try going to bed at 5 for a couple of weeks and see if that helps. All right.
Okay, thank you, Chris.
There's no fun feeling sleepy at work all the time. That's just awful.
It's horrible sometimes.
Chris Reardon, giving advice to the millions. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris.
Just before you go, that could be another feature. Chris Reardon gives advice. What do you think?
Thought of the day.
Ta-da, Danny.
Take care. Bye bye.
Oh, yeah. Danny Davies in Wales. He's a nice lad. Poor sod, though, getting up at that time of the day. Oh, my word. It must be awful feeling sleepy at work. Mind you, on Thursdays, I do the Pace and Clapham, the two brews on Thursdays. And often I get a bit tired there because that's my late one. I work until 2 a.m. And at that one, I'm kind of, it gets to about 1 o'clock and I start getting tired there. So yeah, it's one of those things, isn't it? Dino wanted to know what the phone number is. Yeah, it's come up on this side there. Oh, am I missing messages here? Hang on, what have I done? I think I might have done something wrong. One moment, please. Let me try and catch up with you all again, boys and girls. Bam, bam. Push that one, push that there. 020-8144-3... Oh, there he goes. Dino's there. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number today. Have we done something... I don't know if I've done something wrong here. Oh, dear, dear me. What have I done? There we are. Okay. Okay, let's do some of today's stories then, boys and girls. Here's one. The Secretary of State for Environment, Food and Rural Affairs. Now, that's a name and a half, isn't it? What a name and a half that was. Has advised the British public to keep £5 notes refrigerated before use. It follows confirmation by a government scientist that there is a risk of your £5 notes of degradation due to the high meat content of the new £5 note, and the storage guidelines should apply. Now, you may have heard this in the news a few months ago now, it was, where vegetarians had contacted the government because there is like a meat content. There's a bit of a meat content in £5 notes. Did you know that? No, you didn't, did you? The Bank of England is under pressure to find a solution to the problem, which has seen members of the public complain of blood-stained pockets and maggot-infested wallets. It's all very worrying, dear. This is due to the new £5 notes. And they're bringing out tenors. Aren't they bringing out tenors soon as well? I think. The Bank of England has issued a statement in an attempt to restore confidence, declaring that a process of smoke curing future batches of banknotes is likely to take place in order to further prolong their lifespan. So take note of that, boys and girls. If you've got a little stack of five, I must say I don't have many £5 notes. They're the ones that tend to get spent first, aren't they? But people collect various different denominations of money, don't they? Whether it's the big jar, you know, the big jar of coins. I know some people have copper coins. Some people collect pound coins, £2 coins. So presumably, some people would collect £5 notes, wouldn't they? Huh? Maybe you collect 20, maybe you collect £50 notes. How many of those of you have got stashed underneath your bed? Yes. So watch out on that one, boys and girls. You make sure you keep those £5 notes stored carefully in your fridge. Very, very important, all right? Where are we now? Here's something. Do you know anyone who's ever tried to buy back their old house? You know, when you're living somewhere and it's time to sell, when you sell your house. And, you know, it worries me if I ever wanted to move, because I love where I live. I love where I live. I wonder how many people have actually tried to buy back their old house. Do you know anyone who's done that or tried to and failed for whatever reason? You know, because I am sure if I ever decide to leave here and sell up, the next people will come in and I'm pretty sure they will, once they've done it up how they want it, they will fall in love the same as I did in this house. And I just wondered if you knew anyone, or maybe you've tried it yourself, maybe you've sold up and moved, or not even necessarily buying your own house, but maybe you were renting somewhere and you were there for ages and ages, and then you decided to move, and then you thought to yourself, do you know, I prefer it where I was before, but there's someone else in there now. Have you ever tried to get back your rented property? If you do, give us a call, 020-8144-3477. Or if you're watching a replay, just put a little message on there. And I always read the messages out again later on. But that's an interesting thing, because it has bothered me before. You know, I love it here. I do love it here. But where my sister is and my great nieces and nephews, they are calling. I can feel them calling all the time. I'd hate to sell this, move, and then for whatever reason, and sometimes it just doesn't work out. There could be a million reasons that something like that doesn't work out. And you want to come back to the house that you had before, but you can't. Someone else has bought it, or someone else is, you know, renting it. Do you know anyone who's done that before? I tried to go back to the house that they used to be in. I'm not talking about, of course, if you got married and moved away and you want to go back with your mum and dad, I can understand that. I'm sure that wouldn't be a problem. Anyway, let us know. 020-8144-3477. Skype in on the Skype name, United Kingdom Talk, or put a little message underneath what we're doing today, and I'll read those out as well. All right, boys and girls. Let's see, what else have we got here today? There we go. Now, there's a there's a little story in this morning's Mail Online that says, Daddy's little idol. Eric Cowell is the spitting image of his father, Simon, as he joins glam mum Laura Silverman for a spot of fine dining in Malibu. And I'm looking at this little boy. Does he look like Simon Cowell? A little bit. But where it says spitting image of his father, Simon, well, I'm looking. Number one, he's not fat. Number two, he hasn't got those stupid glasses on. And number three, this little boy actually dresses reasonably well. You know what I mean? So how can they say it's a spitting image of Simon Cowell? The story says, as he made his way through the sundress, he's only about, oh, I don't know how old he is, about 4 or 5 years old. As he made his way through the sun-drenched parking lot, he held his hand of his mother, who looked glamorous in an off-the-shoulder brown tasseled sweater. Have you got a tasseled sweater? With black jeans and camel high heels. With a black leather jacket draped over his arm, she shielded her eyes from the southern court. Is it a her or a him? With a black leather... Oh, he's talking about the woman now. Is it a wife or a girlfriend? I don't know. She shielded her eyes from the Southern California sunshine with a pair of stylish tinted shades, while her raven tressels were styled in long, luxurious waves. But the little boy there doesn't look anything like Simon. Okay, maybe the facial features slightly. But he's got a dress sense. He's not fat. And he doesn't walk around looking like he owns the place. So I don't see how that looks like Simon Cowell. Dear, dear me. I don't know. In the sun today... Here are the two things that you should never do if you wake up in the middle of the night. Do you do that? I mentioned that right at the beginning of the show today. Who wakes up in the middle of the night? When the ghosts and the ghouls are waiting to get you. Yes. If you want to drift off back to sleep after suddenly waking, you should never do these two things. Here we go. It goes, there's nothing worse than knowing you have an early start the next morning and then suddenly waking up in the middle of the night. Now, for me, it's worse when, for example, if I was going on a holiday somewhere, not on a caravan holiday, if I was flying somewhere, generally the night before I have the most terrible trouble sleeping. I just worry all the time. It's one of the reasons I don't fly anymore. It says, once you're awake, sleep seems then to evade you and you end up lying there, wide-eyed, willing yourself to drift back off. But of course you can't. But now, a sleep specialist has revealed the two things you should never do if you suddenly wake up during the night and want to get back to sleep. And they both involve not leaving your bed or even opening your eyes. Dr. Michael Breas, a sleep expert and author, says the first thing you should do, the first thing you should never do if you wake up is to go to the bathroom unless you really need to. Oh, I need to. I have to go about twice a night. I go. We have to have a wee, don't you? You can't just like. What if you wake and you wet the bed? You don't want to be wet in the bed. Not on my John Lewis mattress topper, dear. I've only had that a few months around Christmas. I bought that. Oh, it's lovely. You must get one. John Lewis Downproof Mattress Topper. Luxury that you've never experienced before once you've got one of those. I don't want to wee on it. Got to get up. Got to go up. He told The Independent that when you get out of bed or to stumble to the bathroom or even decide to sit up, it causes your heart rate to increase. When drifting off to sleep, your heart rate lowers as you relax, but it is raised. You find it difficult to start knocking out the... What's that? Oh, knocking out the Zeds again. I wonder what that was going to say then. Stop it. Meanwhile, the second thing you should never do means you have to fight every instinct you have. According to Dr. Bruce, if you wake, you should never reach for your phone or even look at your alarm clock for the time. Now, I know the phone one because that light on the phone is a little bit bright, isn't it? Although I've set my phone now and it's like a much dimmer screen at certain times of the day. He explains that looking at the time causes the brain to become agitated and stressed. Are you feeling agitated and stressed today? Are you feeling a little bit agitated and stressed? I'm sure you are. Which are the two worst feelings if you want to drop back off. So next time you wake up in the middle of the night, you don't have to, don't move or even open your eyes. And if you've ever wondered what time you should be going to bed, we told you when you should be going to sleep if you want up feeling fresh. Well, we tried that the other day, didn't I? And it didn't work. Shall I try it again? Let's try it again. Hang on a minute. Oh, no, it's a bit different for me, though. It's not pointless me doing it because it's going to be different for me to you because I would do all funny hours. So there we are. Don't open your eyes or move. Just lay there. Just lay there and never, ever move, OK? Very, very bad. Very, very bad. Let's do some of your messages coming in on the show this afternoon. Thank you, as always, your wonderful messages that you send in. Ashley says, Chris, I watched your video last night from what you did the other day about what's the latest you stayed out till. Well, when I was a late teen, early 20s, I went to Ministry of Sound. Ah, yes. And didn't get home till gone 7 in the morning. Also, I wake up sometimes after midnight. Oh, do you? 7 in the morning. Oh, that's nothing. At 7 in the morning? Is that all? 7 in the morning. Ashley, I used to go to trade. Opens at like 3:30 in the morning. I used to get about 4:30. And I used to get back here in my house at about 3:00 in the afternoon. And I did that for about 4 or 5 years. Oh, it was wonderful. I loved it. Never got to the Ministry of Sound. I knew a young lady who ran that place for a while, or ran the bar there. Charlotte, she's a lovely girl, Charlotte. Charlotte Smith's her name. She was running the bar there for quite a few years. And she gave it up in the end because of the late nights, I think. Good afternoon to Wendy, who's joining us this afternoon. Afternoon, Wendy. Adam says, don't sell the United Kingdom Talk Studios. Rent them out and use the money to pay the mortgage if you go up north. Now, that's a good idea, isn't it? Let's just move around. Let's just move around. So actually, if you wanted to move, I mean, that's an excellent idea. I could rent this out for X amount. And if you're going north, you're always going to pay less than what it would cost here. So yeah, you're absolutely right there. Excuse me, I hiccup in there. You're absolutely right there, Adam. You could rent out the place you've got down south to pay for your place up north. That would work. That would work very well. Thank you. Was that your mum's house, Chris? What do you mean? What, where I am now? No, this isn't my mum's house. No, my mum's house is in Roehampton. All right. What's trade like, dear? Oh, it's not open anymore, trade. That finished ages ago, I'm afraid. You missed that. Oh, it was excellent there. Excellent there. Excellent. All right. How's the time going? Oh, I'm feeling a bit peckish now. I need to put my dinner on. Okay. We'll do one more story. One more story. Now, if you're going on holiday, I don't want to worry you. I don't want to worry you here, okay? A devastating mega tsunami. Yes. This is in this morning's Mail again. It's only a matter of time before a giant wall of water smashes into the coast of Spain and Portugal, scientists have warned. Well, it's only down the road, isn't it? Spain and Portugal. It's not like you're on the plane for 24 hours going to Australia, dear. I'd like to go to Spain again. I think, presumably you can sail to Spain, can you? so I wouldn't have to go on a plane. All that mucking around. I'd like to go to Spain for a week, and maybe when it gets cold here, I'd like to go to Benidorm. I'd like to go to the place in Benidorm where they do the excellent TV series written by a very good friend of mine, Darren Lytton. He writes it. He's over there at the moment. They're actually, I don't know, it takes ages to make a TV show. They are actually over there filming for next year's series now. He went a couple of weeks ago. So the series that's on at the moment, that was filmed this time last year. They're actually over there at the moment, all the stars and that, filming the next series of Benidorm for next year. Isn't it hilarious? I love that programme. In a new documentary, they claim that these areas are woefully unprepared for such a catastrophe, which could result in the deaths of at least 1,200 people. The potential carnage has been compared to a cataclysmic earthquake. There's a good word in it. Try and throw that in. Impress your friends with that word today. Cataclysmic. What a word that is. Oh, yes. A cataclysmic earthquake which created a tsunami that killed more than 10,000 people in 18th century Portugal. The claims were made in the film La Gran Ola, or The Great Wave. OK, so there we are. That's in the mail this morning. There's a lot more on that story if you want to read that. A devastating mega tsunami could hit tourist hotspots in Spain and Portugal at any time, killing thousands. You know, so if you're going on the beach there, you know, keep your eyes out, for Christ's sake. Do keep your eyes out. You never know, dear. You never know. Adam says, you can sail to Spain from Southampton. Oh, I might like to do that. I might like to do that. Ashley says, you would love Spain, as my parents got a villa out there in Spain. So try and go one a year. Yeah, I'd like to go to Spain, I think. I think I would like to go to Spain. But not when it's too hot. You know, when it's got colder here, I think it remains warm there for a while, doesn't it? Yeah. Good. Good. Let's do today's birthdays, and then I will reveal which was today's item of fake news. It's all fake news. Happy birthday today to excellent karaoke host. I think his main place is the place in Peckham called Canavans. Canavans, Mike Yates. Happy birthday to a man with great style, that hat and all that business. Mike Yates, happy birthday to you, sir. Hope you have a wonderful day today. Happy birthday to Carol Allen, who's 55 today. To Lisa Allington, 42 today. Happy birthday, Lisa. To James Gibson, 26 years old today. And also to Stephen Bacon. He's no longer with us. He would have been 44 years old today, sadly taken from us some time ago now. He was a top drag queen. He was such a nice person, Stephen Bacon. And towards when he had his cancer, and he was doing these little, not videos, but writing, what was that? Blogs. He was doing little blogs, and they were so funny. They were so funny. And it got to the last one, and it said, my time is nearly up now. I hope you've enjoyed all my blogs. And then we lost him. But what a wonderful man to be able to still keep us laughing right up to the day he went. Isn't that fantastic to be like that? So he would have been here. Stephen Bacon would have been 44 years old today. Happy birthday to you, Stephen. And a real pleasure to work with him as well. Let's sing the song, boys and girls. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mike, Carol, Lisa, Stephen and James. Happy birthday to you. Now, did I say James's birthday? James Gibson is 26 today. I might have left that one off there. Sorry, James. Happy birthday to you as well, sir. OK, so today's item of fake news. Which story do you think it was, boys and girls? Which story do you think the fake news item was today? Have you any idea? Go on, take a wild stab in the dark. A wild stab in the dark. Today's item of fake news was about the £5 banknotes. There is no need to keep £5 banknotes in the fridge. You don't need to do that. When you put them in, there's no meat in there. I think there's some sort of animal fat in there, but there's no meat in there. You're not going to put your hand in your pocket one day and it's going to all blood stain where the meat has leaked out into your pocket or anything like that. That was today's item of fake news. Okay, boys and girls. Well, that's it today. Thank you very much for joining us on the show this morning, boys and girls, or this afternoon. Have a lovely Tuesday. I'm looking forward to a nice night tonight, actually. I'm popping out to see my friend Wayne, who lives near the Thames, actually. I think it's in... Is it Canonbury or somewhere? Canonbury's in North London. Cannon something. Cannon Street. Does that sound about right? It might be Cannon Street. Anyway, I'm meeting up with him tonight, and we're going to have a Domino's pizza around about 9 o'clock or something like that. So that's where I'm going tonight. And who knows when the next show will be? Tomorrow morning at 6 a.m? Only if I wake up. Sometime tomorrow, I'm sure. Thanks so much for joining us. Enjoy your Tuesday, all right? Bye-bye now.